Hey, hi, this is Guju here.
Hi, this is Viju here.
And today we are talking about something very interesting that we came across very recently.
Yeah, in fact, mostly Fridays are,
movie nights, family movie nights together.
Yeah. It's kind of a fun Fridays for us, typically.
Yeah.
Last Friday we saw a movie, and in fact, Tare Zameen Par.
Yes, it's a very nice Hindi movie, Amir Khan.
And talks about the child who's struggling to read, write.
With dyslexia, yes.
Yeah, with dyslexia. Yeah. And how the parents initially treat the child without really knowing the child problem.
Yes.
And later how Amir Khan helps the child to really discover the child's, skills and talents.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's how the whole movie goes. And while in the movie, in between, one of a scene which really
impacted us was very interesting scene, right?
Correct.
Where Amir talks about the story of the people of Solomon Islands.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you guys remember it, but this is a story where apparently the people living in Solomon Islands, if they want to, cut down a tree, they usually do not go and cut it down. So they all gather around the tree and speak words of curse, negativity, hateful words, and apparently after a few days the tree just shrivels and dies over.
Yeah, in fact, too, it's like while I was reading this, when I heard this story, I wanted to also go to the Google and really see whether is this true.
Yeah.
Okay. I know words has a lot of impact.
Absolutely.
On people, and I don't know, is it having this similar impact on things? And other things, other living things.
In fact,
right?
To add to what you're saying, when we're talking about living things, right? There was this experiment which was very recently done by IKEA, and they did this in a school in the Middle East. The experiment was called bullying a plant. Right?
Yes.
I also
saw that. That's exactly what I was also coming to tell her.
Mm-hmm.
When you did a Google, that's when this also
popped up as well.
And IKEA doing this, How many days they did this?
They did this experiment for about 30 days
where
they kept two similar plants and each of the plants were exposed to the same amount of sunlight, water, fertilizer. Everything was same except for the fact that one plant was subjected to praise, positivity, positive words and all the good vibrations that come with the good words, right? While the other plant that was, kept was subjected to hate comments, negativity, bullying. And this experiment they carried out for 30 days.
30 days.
Right? And at the end of the 30 days, it was a no-brainer to find out, just by looking at the two plants, you knew which one was a plant that was, given the positive comments and which was the plant that was given the negativity. Because the plant which was given the positive comments was so glorious, so beautiful, so thriving.
Yeah.
While the other plant had just shriveled up and was really droopy and, leaves were really wrinkled and that kind
so
of
thing. You can see it yourself.
Yes, I think we can put a pic of that as well.
Right.
So.
And how are we going to relate this, our real life? See, fundamentally, we take everything for granted. I always love to say that people hate free things, right? We take everything for granted. We take our words, for granted. We just really don't see how it's going to impact. I've seen, children, they look upon to parents, and sisters look upon to sisters. Even in my own home, I keep seeing this. Whenever people utter bad words, hatred words, that's the one which quickly catches and it spreads like a wildfire. Right?
Absolutely.
Each of them keep picking them. Imagine, what we're doing to our own family, our own community, our own children,
Our own selves.
Our own selves.
Yeah, because there are many times in self-doubt, we say I'm a stupid or I'm a klutz or I'm an idiot. But imagine that each of that word
what you say
that you utter is actually a sound. A sound is a vibration. And a vibration is the way the universe communicates.
Yes.
So just imagine the amount of, negative aura that each of us are creating by using or uttering these kind of words.
Yeah.
So I think as a first step, it's something that we need to very consciously take a decision that we will start to cut down these usage of these negative
words
in our life because every positive word impacts positively.
Yes.
Right? So let's focus on the positive. Let's focus on what we can do to make each other better, make ourselves better. And we would like to, share this understanding, yes, that dawned upon us with while watching this movie.
Exactly. And this is the best time of the year to really think back what happened in 2020. And why don't we all take an oath in 2021, we will consciously watch the words that are coming out of our mouth.
Absolutely.
And let us see how much of more positive that we can spread amongst ourselves and bring in abundance of positivity now in the whole world.
Absolutely. So let's hope 2021 brings in a lot of positivity.
Yes.
And with this, we'll sign off. Stay blessed.
Stay happy.
Bye. Bye.